Hello guys, GT Racing here, and today we are for once not in Assetto Corsa Competizione, but rather in the OG Assetto Corsa. This is because in this video I want to specifically focus on a mod for AC, a paid mod actually. The F1 2020 mod by Race Sim Studios, or rather Formula Hybrid 2020, as this is what the mod is actually called on their page, promises to simulate the current generation of Formula 1 cars better than any other mod out there. Now, this raises a few questions. Is this statement actually true? Is it worth purchasing this mod over buying the actual F1 game by Codemasters? And are there any noticeable cons, as Assetto Corsa in itself isn't really a formula simulation, but was initially coded to simulate a wider spectrum of cars? Well, in this video I'm going to answer all these questions and tell you about the experiences I've made with this mod so far. So let's start off with a short introduction about the mod itself. The Formula 2020 Hybrid mod will cost you about 4 euros, depending on where you come from, since the original product in itself costs about 3 euros and 80 cents, but unlike politicians, you actually have to pay your taxes, which ups the price of the mod to about 4 euros and a bit. What the mod offers in its default package is also fairly realistic. It comes with 3 different tire components, the soft, the medium and the hard tires, and completely implemented ERS system, which can be set to different modes in the setup screen, like harvesting, hot lap or overtake. And this ERS system also will show its current energy levels from the display on your wheel. There's also a DRS system implemented, which can be activated manually and shuts itself down whenever you hit the brakes, which is also fairly realistic considering the current Formula 1 cars also have a similar mechanism in place. However, this very implementation of the DRS in this mod leads me to my first drawback. Whenever you happen to race on a track which wasn't in the original Assetto Corsa game and therefore also doesn't have dedicated DRS zones on the track, you may open your DRS whenever you want. There are no restrictions whatsoever. Additionally, in F1 there is a current rule which only allows DRS usage after the first 3 laps, after the initial start, or after a safety car ends. However, if you watched closely during the first few seconds of this video, you may have noticed that my AI competitors all had their DRS systems wide open as soon as they set off. Now, this isn't particularly annoying, but it definitely doesn't help the immersion. Additionally, the mod only models one instance of a Formula 1 car, meaning, depending on the interpretation, there's only a Mercedes, a Red Bull, a Ferrari or whatever, which essentially displays the whole Formula 1 series as a spec racer series, which on the other hand, if I think about it, wouldn't necessarily be a bad thing, as there was no Mercedes domination for the past 6 years or so. Anyway, to spice up the cars a bit, there is at least a skin pack for all current Formula 1 liveries available on Race Department. But now let's move on to the car's handling and behavior. If you've ever played a Codemasters Formula 1 game before, you'll probably be surprised how far they were off from an actual simulation. At least assuming that this mod in Assetto Corsa is more realistic than their games. Now, what I'm trying to say is not that one of the games is completely unrealistic while the other one is a high-end simulation, but rather that the Race Sim Studios mod feels completely different to the cars made by Codemasters. The cars feel planted, have massive grip, and you can really push them. But if you decide to do so, you risk actually overheating your tires, which in turn will force you to run one or two cooldown laps, as your car otherwise will gradually get more and more undrivable over time. A small tip that I can give you to make the cars easier to drive is to reduce your brake pressures to about 90%, as it will help you greatly with not locking up your wheels. However, as the race in the background is slowly coming to an end, It is now time for me to come up with a conclusion and briefly answer the questions I raised in the beginning of the video. The Formula 2020 Hybrid mod comes with a fairly realistic package, which includes all three tire components real F1 cars use, as well as an ERS system and a somewhat decently working DRS system. However, there are some exploits which, depending on the situation, can greatly reduce your immersion. Overall, these cars have massive grip and you can really push them. You can also have some nice battles with the AI, but I somehow feel that the higher speeds mess a bit with them and car contacts are a lot more common than usual. If you prefer physics over a decently done single player mode, you should invest in a mod rather than in the Codemasters F1 game. If you are not too sure about whether the physics of these cars are actually as great as I praise them to be, you can go to the Race Sim Studios shop and, for example, purchase the Formula Hybrid 2017 cars, as they are currently available for free. And if you by now think that the mod is not worth its money, then go and buy the Formula 1 game done by Codemasters. So yeah, that was it from my side for this video, and I hope that I could give you a brief overview of the Racing Studios mod and eventually help you to decide whether you purchase this mod or not. If you did enjoy this video, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers, guys!